back in the 90s, 911 were huge in the UK. And thanks to ITV2's The Big Reunion, Spike, Lee and Jimmy are back. I am very pleased to say Spike Dawbarn is joining me now. Hello, Spike. How are you doing?
I'm fine. How are you?
I'm not too bad. Not too bad.
Wicked.
So ITV2's Big Reunion, for those who haven't seen it, it features yourselves, Atomic Kitten, Bewitched, Liberty X, Five and The Honeys. And you're all heading out on a Big Reunion tour. So when you were first contacted about the show and the possibility of a reunion, what were your first thoughts?
Well, I wasn't up for it, to be honest. I wasn't up for doing it. I was a bit kind of, I have my son and I just didn't want the hassle of it all again. I got talked round by the lad. To be honest, it's probably the best thing we've done in 911. Back in the day, you just did it. And it was easy and you were doing it where this was different because you don't know how people are going to react to you now. So you were more nervous this time round, which made it more exciting.
Now, on the programme, we saw you and the rest of the band, you talk quite openly about your past issues. Was it difficult to bring all that up again?
After all those empty pint glasses had been finished. When we said, right, yeah, we'll do it, we said, we're just going to be totally honest and let people see exactly what it was like and what you go through. With that group chat, they just sat down and we talked for 6 hours. Like, he's edited very small, but we were actually at it for 6 hours at each other. So it was quite mad.
I've got to say, there must be so much that kind of goes on that the public don't see.
Yeah, we did so much filming for the show. And you know, it's showing exactly what does go on behind closed doors with a band and what you actually go through, because people just see him on it, and they think, oh, it's brilliant and all that. Whereas who's done it, we look at him and think, you do feel sorry for him.
Now, being in a band so young, there must have been so much pressure. If you could go back to the 90s and speak to your former self, what would you say? Would you give any advice to yourself?
Probably not to quit like we did, because we got out before our time, really.
Mm.
We could have kept going for another at least 2 years, you know, before I reckon we would have had to. Or you quit because you've had enough, you really have had enough.
Mm.
And you just call it a day, and then 6 months later, you want back into it, but it's gone. It's weird. It's kind of hanging yourself. If I went back, I'd probably tell myself not quit when I did.
Now, the show, I'm going to be quite honest with you, it does make you out to be a bit of a ladies' man. Was this always the case back then, or were the others just as bad?
All of them were just as bad. They just pissed on me. Now, back then, you were 18, 17, 18, 19, you just had a laugh. You were in other countries, and it was just good fun, but, you know, I'm not like that anymore. It was just back then. You know what I mean? You're talking about how you used to be, and everyone thinks I'm like that, and I'm like, not like it anymore.
I've got to say, you do, you grow up, don't you? I mean,
yeah.
Do you look at, like, people like Harry Styles, and you think, oh, I were there once, that were me?
Yeah, big time. I might go on that. Enjoy yourself.
Oh, bless him. Obviously, we've just talked about the girls and everything. Have you ever had any interesting gifts sent by fans?
You got a lot of naughty stuff, but you got a lot of, like, weird stuff. You know, like, I think I once, in a box, got sent a load of toenails.
Oh, God.
It's like, what? What are you going to do with them?
Let's just hope they were clean ones, eh? Oh,
I know, tell me about it. But, yeah, you do, you know, you do get sent a lot of mad stuff.
How do you get on with the other groups that are on the Big Reunion?
Really well, because we knew each other back, you know, back then. It's weird, because you're on a TV show, you're all in it together, so you want a TV show do well. So you don't have that competition with each other.
That's it. What's the atmosphere like? Is it a good atmosphere? Is there a good buzz?
Yeah. It's been during filming, there was a lot of late nights drinking and that. Not having a laugh. Yeah, because there's a lot of history between the bands as well, so.
Spike, you're a Warrington boy.
Yeah.
I went to uni in Warrington.
Well, Paget
campus, Paget till I die. I don't know if you watched the Jonathan Ross show the other night, but Jack Whitehall was on, and he was absolutely slating it.
Warrington?
He was slating Warrington, yeah.
Why?
Because he did a gig, and it didn't go down well at all. I wasn't actually there, but I think I'd gone out into Liverpool or something that night, and everyone
it was
who
comedy.
It was comedy, yeah. But everyone who was there, he got absolutely slated, and he
the
just
thing
said.
Is with Warrington, you see it on the show,
yeah.
Like Warrington people say how it is,
yeah, definitely.
But you look at Kerry, we just say it how it is. if we don't like something, we say, we don't like do all that bitching behind bats and all that. And that's where I think, because Jay was in five and he was from Warrington and used Daniel Allenby and that.
Mm.
And he said, oh, he bullied him and all that. I don't think he did. I think he just told him what he thought.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I think they might have done a bit bitch where he probably just went up and wanted it. Because that's like what he doesn't like. So I can understand why he got a bit sick.
I'm about to say, I think it's when people come across with that, especially with the snotty attitude.
Yeah,
I mean, I like Jack Whitehall. I think he's a good comedian. Back then, if you hadn't seen any of his stuff before, you would just think, you know, who's this snotty young chap, you know, coming on telling us what for? And they gave him what for, it were.
Yeah, I think with Warrington, it's kind of the Pinter Cave and all that. The real, you know, kind of the comedians who talk about real life. I mean,
yeah.
They're the kind of comedians they like. How's Bradford?
Bradford's brilliant.
How's the Bulls doing?
A lot of my mates are Rhinos fans, so I get a lot of stick for that. You see, especially because they're beating us at the minute, so.
Yeah.
Not good.
I used to do all Bradford Bulls Entertainment years ago.
Back in the day.
I know them quite well. Supporting myself.
We broadcast the Bulls games here on BCB, yeah. So it's all good fun. All good fun.
Nah, wicked.
So, Spike, what's next for 911?
There's a lot of offers on the table. We're releasing Body Shaking again. We've re-recorded Body Shaking.
Oh.
Just because we're getting misers for it, and a record company asked us. So I think that'll be coming. I think we're going to be doing a new video for it soon. So that'll probably be coming out in the next 5 to 6 weeks.
You should get all the Bulls cheerleaders in background.
Well, it was me who provided them all.
There we go.
Do you know who I had in my Bradford Bulls? Is it like a boy cheerleader?
Who?
George Sampson.
Really?
Yeah. I had loads on, because I trained George Sampson, so
crikey.
I had him on there.
Now, do you know what? One of my favourite songs that you ever did, The Journey.
What?
Absolutely love that song. My brother used to do it at karaoke all the time. He's a good singer, is our Phil, and he used to do that one, and the room was just silent, because it's such a good song, and I think you should really re-release that one.
Body Shaking is the only one we're going to redo. We are going in studio to look at doing a new album, so...
Right, well, thank you very, very much, Fike. Wonderful. Well, I hope you have a good tour.
Thanks, you'll be a laugh.
And come back to Bradford.
Yeah, we will.
All right. Cheers, bye.
Okay,
bye.
Cheers, bye.